All right, welcome to my channel once again. As I told you, I've been touring Ghana, and this is something that I've actually taken upon myself to do, to show you some popular towns in Ghana and also some villages and cities that we have in Ghana, basically. So that's what I'm doing today. I am in Michael Blackson's village or town. I would say town because it seems like they have almost everything, so I'll call it a town. I am in Michael Blackson's town, and I'm showing you the whole town, the way how the town looks like, and I'll tell you certain things about the town. So you, if you haven't subscribed to the channel, subscribe to the channel and like the video, like this video, because that's what helps me. That's what is going to push this video for more people to also see. So follow me and let's go. I'm showing you everything that you need to see, and we are definitely going to go to where he built his school, the new school that he built, and it's free. It's free. That school is very free. So he's even looking for people to donate to the school because he built it by himself and he needs funds to maintain the school and also keep the school going. So try and donate. Try and donate. So let's go.
This is Agona Nsaba. Agona Nsaba is in the central region of Ghana. It is located on the Agona Swedru SWERU Dyn Road. Agona Nsaba is in the Agona East District, and that is the capital of the Agona East District. The people of Agona Nsaba, they celebrate Akwambo. That is Ewuku Dai and Akwisi Dai around October and November. Their major occupation in this town is farming, mainly cocoa farmers. I spoke to some people or some elders in this town, and one thing that they told me was there are no jobs in the town, and if you are somebody who is willing to come and invest and create jobs, for example like a factory or anything that can create jobs for the youth of the town, even when it comes to land, they are not going to sell land to you. Perhaps if you need a particular location, and that particular location is for somebody, you will just compensate the person and they will give you the land for you to build whatever factory or company that will be able to employ some of the youth in the town, because there are no jobs in the town. The town is very quiet, and I'm going to show you, take you through the town for you to see how the town looks like. So Agona Nsaba, the people of Agona Nsaba migrated from Techiman, and the name Agona Nsaba came about when the people migrated from Techiman. Their main occupation, or what they were doing then in those days, was beating sponge. You know, we have local sponge. We have a very local sponge that they used to beat. If That's how they make the sponge. And it seems like they were some of the pioneers of that particular sponge, type of sponge. So if you go to Agona Nsaba, or you want that type of sponge to buy, you are going to be directed to this current Agona Nsaba. That's go there and you will get some of the sponge to buy. So I'm telling you to go to Agona Nsaba to buy sponge. They will say Nsaburi, because the people are people of the Agona tribe. So we have Agona Swedru, we have Agona Nsaba, we have Agona Konyaku. All these people are the same people, but it's just that they getting that Nsaba name came from beating of that sponge. Nsaburi. And today we have Agona Nsaba or Nsaburi. So that's how the name Agona Nsaba came about. I even learned in Ghana, we in our history, we have a bond that was signed by some chiefs, and the chief then, that's the bond of 1844. Every Ghanaian student knows this. I learned the chief then, who was the chief of Agona Nsaba or Agona Nsaba, was part of the chiefs that signed that bond, the bond of 1844. I spoke with the people, I spoke with the elders, some elders in the town, and they told me one thing that they need, like something that they really, really need in the town, is for someone to come and open a gas filling station. Because if they are supposed to buy gas, they go far away, next town, to buy a gas. And I think there are quite a number of people. I think the town is about 40,000 people. 40,000 people in the town. So having such a population and there is no gas filling station in the town, it's something else. So they have so many things that they need in the town. And if you would want to talk to some of the elders in the town, don't hesitate to DM me on all my social media platforms, and we will talk, and I will just let you see or talk to these people. Because if you are ready to invest, I'm telling you, it's a very good place for you to invest. The only problem that I have is the road connecting Agona Swedru to Agona Nsaba. And even when after Agona Nsaba you go into Akimoda, that road is very bad. But I learned MICHEAL BLACKSON, he is from there, and that's something that I heard. I don't know how true it is though, but I heard that he is actually planning on meeting the government officials, some government officials, so that they fix this particular road, because it's very bad. So without talking too much, without talking plenty, let me take you through the town and let's look at the way the town looks like. So let's go. Don't forget to like the video. You don't lose anything by liking. Just like the video. Let's go.
Okay, so it seems like this is their cemetery, and this is where they bury their dead, and this is their cemetery. This right here that you see, this building, is their district assembly building. This is their district assembly building. So I'm taking you through the town for you to see how the town looks like. So we are going, let's go. Okay, so the driver is telling me this area is called Ajempahe in Nsaba. Ajempahe in Nsaba. So this is their district hospital. Yes, I think this is their district hospital. If you can see, this is their district hospital. So I've shown you that their district assembly, and this is also their district hospital. So I'm showing you through the, like, I'm just taking you through the town for you to see the town. I'm very sure they have a lot of dignitaries who are from this place, but one person that I cannot forget his name is Michael Blackson, the American Ghanaian comedian who recently came to build a school for the town. So if you have a kid, you can take that kid to that school. I learned he has an academy also, football academy, that soccer academy. Yes, so he has that one too in this town. He's actually doing a lot for the town because this is where he's from. His mom is here. That's like that, like, this is where he's from, so he's just doing something to support. One thing that I don't like is the road. The road in this, even when I was coming, the road leading from Swedru, Agona Swedru, to Nsaba is crazy. And this is a road that leads you to Oda, and the same road that will take you to NKRUMAH, Duyakwa, Akrosu, all these places. And the road is very bad, honestly. The road is very, very bad. The road is very, very bad. So I'm just giving you a raw footage of what is happening and the town itself. This is how the town looks like. We're actually getting closer to the center of the town. We're actually getting closer to the center of the town, and I just like how cool and calm the place is, because I always say people come to Ghana and they are like, Ghana is peaceful, Ghana is peaceful, Ghana is peaceful. But I tell you, there are places like this which are much more peaceful than even Accra. Ghana, you say, is peaceful, but trust me, when you come to Ghana, don't just stay in Accra. And I'm telling you, don't just stay in Accra. Go outside Accra and you are going to even enjoy Ghana more than you living in Accra. Okay, so the driver is telling me this place is called Chapel Square in Agona Nsaba. Agona Nsaba. This place is called. They have some few nice buildings around. It's not a big town. So this is like the center of the town, if I'm not mistaken. This is like the center of the town because you can see shops. Okay, so the center of the town is called Ahimbrom because this is their palace. If you can see, this is their palace, Agona Nsaba or Manhene's palace. This is their palace. Okay.
as you can see, I'm just taking you through. I just want you to see how the town looks like. I just want you to see how the town looks like. It's actually a very cool place. Not too much activities is going on, but I can say electricity company office. That's the electricity company office for this district or this town. And this is a church. This is a Presby church in Nsaba, Agona Nsaba. This is a Presby church in Agona Nsaba. Okay. A secondary school in
this house.
Ah, okay, okay. So this is their secondary school, and that's the. We are passing in front of the school just to show you. They have a secondary school, and I think this secondary school is very popular. I'm very sure it has produced a lot of dignitaries in this country. This is the school. This is the entrance of the school in Nsaba Presbyterian Senior High. Okay, okay, okay. And this is their primary. So this is basically. Like the junior high school and the primary, and they have their church here. I think this is the old church, and that's the new church, as you can see. It's actually a cool place, I must say. Not too much activities is going on. So basically, this is the town. This is the town. It's actually not a big town. I will not call it a village because I think they have a lot of things. Everything that you, perhaps a town will need, because they have a police station, they have hospitals, they have district assemblies, they have schools, secondary schools.
Education office.
Okay, this is the education office. That's the Agona Nsaba education office. This is the education office, and it seems it has been closed. I don't even know why. It is closed. Today is Friday, but I don't know, they are closed, so let's go. So this is like the town, as you can see. Because we are on a hilly area, and as you can see the town. Because of these things, I think because of these things that mostly you see lots of the youth will just migrate from their towns and go to Accra, because there is not much going on in this place. Not much, like nothing is going on in this place. And if you are a young guy and you are here and you want to want a better life for yourself, definitely you are going to travel, because when you look at this town, nothing, like what activity, what work. The people here are farmers basically, and nowadays the youth that come, the youth that are in the country right now, or in this generation, how many of them want to be farmers? So they just want quick money, and they will just travel outside and go and do whatever work that they feel they can do. So this is their police station. This is their police station, and as I said, that's the saddest part, you know. People just travel from the town, because I'm touring this place, and you can clearly see that nothing much is going on. Nothing much is going on, and definitely when that happens, the youth are definitely going to migrate from the small towns to the big cities and just find something to do so that they can earn something for themselves. So these are some of the things. These are some of the things. This is also a church, the Pentecostal church. This building that you see right here is a church, Pentecostal church, from this town, Agona Nsaba. Agona Nsaba, in the central region of Ghana. In the central region of Ghana. This is where Michael Blackson is from. This is where Michael Blackson is from. Michael Blackson's town. This is where he's from. I will be taking you, as we are going to where he built his school. And I learned some people that own private schools here. Some private schools in the town are not really happy because his school is free, and for the private schools they are charging money. So if a small town like this, and you have built such a school and the school is free, just imagine. Definitely, why, like, who doesn't want free things? So definitely these people are going to go to the free schools that that Michael Blackson has built. And when you look at the facility that he has built, actually it's very beautiful. So this is a mosque, Zongo Lane. Zongo, when we talk about Zongo, in we all, you know, we have Zongos in every community in Ghana, every village, every town in Ghana. Some towns have multiple Zongos, and that's like a Muslim community in Ghana. Yes. Taking you to Michael Blackson's school, where the school is. I am taking you to where the school is. club or a place that nightlife goes on here. You know, in Ghana, nightlife is everything for us. So hey, they chill. So this is Michael Blackson's school. This is the school, and I learned he built a house attached to it for his mom. Yes, for his mom, Michael Blackson's Academy. Let me get down. Okay, I think I learned the students have vacated, and also it seems someone from Michael's family is no more. So my condolences to the family. That's the reason why they are not allowing people to even enter the school, because it's not just the school, they have their house too here. So you can imagine. Yes, so I'm going to fly my drone so that you see the town itself, including this place and everything. So don't worry, I'm sure you are going to do this next time when I come. Okay, Bosu, thank you. Yeah.